Paltrocast.
Tom, John, Seth, a pleasure. Thank you for having me. Congratulations on another season of the show happening. I don't know who this question goes to first. Did you know that this was a Hulu show all along, or were they just the right partner for it?
Oh, no, no. Well, Tom, you can probably even speak to that.
Well, the gestation of the show was really long. And so we kind of knew what the show was going to be in stages. And we developed the show with Sony before it sold to Hulu. You know, the show didn't really crystallize until it became a Hulu show for sure. So, you know, by the time we were actually making the show, it was definitely a Hulu show.
And at that time, there just wasn't any other place that was going to make it the way that we wanted to make it.
Makes sense to me. And Hulu announced a second season for the show 6 days after the premiere of the first season, which kind of tells you, hey, this network believes in the show per se. Did you know long before those 6 days, hey, there was going to be a second season and you had to sit on that?
Well, we didn't find out by reading it in the paper, but I can't remember. I can't remember how long before we found out, but like the getting renewed for another season is always this conversation that goes back and forth, and there are a lot of parties involved, and it's way less exciting than picking up the phone and it's like, you're renewed, and the champagne corks are popping, and I wish it was that exciting, but it's a lot more boring than that. But it was great news, and it was great when it got announced publicly, because they don't have to do that. You know, they could say, okay, you're renewed, don't tell anybody, which they do a lot, because they're like, because we might still cancel you is the underlying message there.
Right.
But it was great when they said, and we're going to tell the world you're renewed. We were like, oh, that's a great vote of confidence.
They've been incredibly supportive.
Yeah.
Well, my money's on Seth for this one. I'm wondering who's the genius that got Plinko into this season.
Well, I definitely can't claim credit for that. We all love Plinko. The Price is Right itself is iconic in all of our lives, and any opportunity to replicate any of those games, but especially the legendary Plinko, who would pass that up? But I didn't pitch that.
Wow.
No, okay. Yeah, I think because we knew the Leprechauns were going to play a game show, and we were like, well, what are some iconic game show games they could be playing? And Plinko is just one of the most iconic ones. I think we wanted the Mountain Climber game too, but.
I love that one.
The Mountain Climber.
That's visually stunning, Mountain Climber. What would be the second place game show? Would it be Press Your Luck that iconically you would play?
For me, I love Press Your Luck more than any other game show because it had animation in it.
Yeah.
And it was topical humor. the whammy would come out and he would be Michael Jackson. And like, oh my God, I can't believe how do they animate this so fast?
That's amazing.
Probably Wheel of Fortune or Jeopardy would be.
Whoa, Seth just said Card Sharks. Okay.
I did. Yeah, we've had this conversation. It's actually it might even be in the first episode of Robot Chicken in one of the original channel flips when we still thought channel flips were something random and disconnected. A guy turns over a card and says, oh, no, it was not higher, it was lower. And I just loved that the entire mechanics of this game rested on chance and the 50-50 opportunity for any player to win something. And everyone acted like they had a strategy. There's no strategy. You just guess. You guess and you're right or you're wrong. There's something magical about that.
Well, I have two quick questions. One is going to promote Hulu and one is not. I was wondering if I could get a pick for best game show theme song of all time from each of you.
Well, I do love The Price is Right.
Less of Concentration.
Hamlet's always in my head.
I'll go Jeopardy just to be different.
Oh, that's a good one.
Because it's become Like you can hum that and it has this context. You can hum it out of context and people know exactly what you're, what it means. That's it's like, hurry up and think of an answer, idiot.
Wow. Next question, besides Crossing Swords, what's the best show on Hulu, according to each of you?
Ooh, I love that What If show.
I love Pen 15. I think I'll go...
I've seen all seasons of Future Man.
Say that again?
Future Man.
Oh, Future Man, yeah.
Yeah, that show is hilarious.
Okay.
Harv?
I'll go with The Great.
Oh my God, how did we not even talk about that? We're talking about that on every other call.
You left
it. Yeah, The Great. Season two of The Great just started, and God, it is good.
It's awesome.
There are too many good shows on Hulu for too little amount of money. That's the problem with Hulu.
And then last, before I let you go, who's the second biggest fan of Van Halen besides Breckenmeyer involved in the show?
I don't know. Is it you, Tom?
You know, I can't say I'm the biggest Van Halen fan because I discount the entire Sammy Hagar run.
Yeah, I'm a Van Hagar fan more than...
But wait. It's a trick question because you're assuming that Brecken is a ride or die Van Halen fan.
He is.
I can't believe you just took that at face value.
He was at the secret Van Halen show before the tour started. But anyway, gentlemen, that was my time. Thank you all for this. Keep up the greatness and looking forward to season three if and when that happens.
All right. Thanks, Darren. Thank you so much.
Thanks, guys. Take care.
Bye-bye. Paltrocast.